After 25 years, the Toon Squad is finally back, now with LeBron James taking over the place of Michael Jordan, but the main star still remaining, Bugs Bunny. This is my review of Space Jam, A New Legacy. LeBron James takes his son on a field day to the Warner Brothers lot, but soon a rogue artificial intelligence kidnaps his son, and he now has to work with Bugs Bunny to win a basketball game unlike any other. Before I start with my review, I want to know your thoughts on this film. If you love the original Space Jam, if you're looking forward to this one, let me know all of that in the comments below. Throw it all down there and let me know what is your favorite Looney Tune. That is the most important question, and it's also the most important part for you to start the conversation. While down there, if you're new to the channel, first of all, thank you for clicking on this video. Why don't you consider clicking the subscribe button? It does wonders to get the content out there. You'll help the channel a ton and you'll join a beautiful film fan community. It's fair to say I was not looking forward to this film very much. The trailer made it look just like Ready Player One with a Space Jam dressing to it. I just rewatched the original and it doesn't hold up very well, even though it's still a fun film for what it is. This film worked for me. First of all, I respect this movie a lot for not just doing the same thing over and over again. It takes advantage of the time that has passed. It takes advantage of new technologies that we have now available for filmmaking, integrating live action characters with CG elements and vice versa. And it does that very well. The visual effects in this film are stellar. The visuals in general are spectacular. They're extremely creative. This film goes out there. It goes nuts. It goes insane. It has fun with itself. Some of my favorite sequences in the film are when LeBron and Bugs Bunny and the rest of the Looney Tunes are in 2D. There's a ton of fun to be had there. There's so many crazy references, crazy Easter eggs. They visit a lot of really fun worlds in a really fun way. There's a particular one that is held close to my heart, and so I loved to see it. And the film is also extremely self-aware. The setup for this film is basically LeBron goes into this hearing with Warner Brothers where they have this new technology called Warner 3000, in which they can digitally create a rendering of LeBron James and then just insert him into movies. We can have Godzilla versus LeBron James, Batman versus LeBron James, and when they have this little demonstration, LeBron James beats Batman, which just doesn't sit right with me, and I hope doesn't sit right with anyone else. And they're self-aware to the point where LeBron rejects this idea because athletes aren't meant to act in movies. He's right. That's all I'm going to say. And the film does give a lot of screen time to the Looney Tunes themselves. Their crazy antics, their personalities are able to shine through the screen. A lot of the gags that they have are there because of who they are and the relationships between them. They give most of them, if not all, a real spotlight moment. They gave my boy, Willie Coyote, a spotlight moment. He's there. He does something really big. I love them for it. And kudos to Zendaya playing Lola Bunny. She does a great job. She fits really organically amongst these crazy, wacky characters that we know and love and recognize their voices. And she now is the famous basketball player amongst the Looney Tunes because she did such a great job in the original Space Jam. I love those little references. And this film doesn't really stick to them. They have references here and there. There's one visual reference that I loved, but the canon, quote-unquote, raises a lot of questions. So if you're going to this to see a really faithful sequel to Space Jam that embraces the original, this ain't it for the most part. And honestly, there is a predictable, by the numbers, but for what this movie is, an effective father-son narrative that they hang on to from beginning to end. And again, I respect them a lot for doing something different, doing something creative, and having fun with it. They're self-aware and they give no shits. A lot of the time of this film is dedicated to the actual game. Like, the second half of the film entirely is just these characters playing the basketball game that they have to play, and they dive into it completely. It's actually an insane game that works with cartoon logic, and again, full respect to this film. Not to say that this is a great film. It's not. It's really fun, but it is still an overly long mess. It's just 5 minutes shy of 2 hours with so much crammed in there just for you to see all the things that Warner Brothers owns just for the sake of it. This entire film, on its background, it's basically a giant flex of Warner Brothers. And that can be distracting a lot of times. There are some jokes and some background characters that are in there that don't fit this whatsoever, don't fit this narrative, and we just verge onto them quickly for you to notice that Warner Brothers, yeah, they own these characters and these properties, so what? What did they add to the film? They add nothing. The film is also riddled with celebrity cameos that I have no idea why they're there. Again, it's fun to see celebrities, I guess, but did this film need it? No, we're here to see the Looney Tunes, and I'm sure some people are here to see LeBron James, but not these random celebrities that we'll recognize for the sake of it. Space Jam A New Legacy is bloated, but it is in reality a Saturday morning cartoon, and it recognizes that it is that first and foremost. It delivers on the fun, it delivers on the comedy, it delivers on letting the Looney Tunes shine, and LeBron James is there in the midst somewhere. I'm giving Space Jam A New Legacy a C+. Thank you so much for watching. You are the best. What is your favorite Looney Tune? How do you compare the Space Jam movies? Drop them all in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. You are the best. I still have to give you my review for Escape Room 2 and Shaman King this week. That will come out tomorrow, and I hope to see you there. So until then, love each other and love the movies.